Hey YouTube, what is up everybody? How's it going? I'm Septic Don 4. We're going to be doing a boxing workout. Pretty much, I did a calisthenics workout before this video. Yes, you can see I'm a little sweaty. I did an hour workout earlier today. I decided to do some more videos today because I was kind of bored. I hadn't really done much today other than just relaxed off and on today and kind of worked some of this day during Thanksgiving. I hope you all had a wonderful Thanksgiving weekend and stuff like that. But we're going to do a boxing workout. It's going to be basic stuff, nothing fancy, you know. We're going to do a jab. We're going to do a jab 20 times on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. We're going to do jab, same time. When you punch, you want to hit with these two knuckles. You don't want to hit with these bottom knuckles. You want to hit with the first two knuckles. Plus, you want to make it a fist. You bring your curved fingers down like this. Have your thumb over the first two index finger. And make it tight. And then when you punch, you shoot it out. You use your hip into it and hit behind the target itself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Alright. What we're going to do is we're going to do jab, cross, jab, cross, 1, jab, cross, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. When you hear me doing that at the end of the technique, that's the breathing and the timing that it's supposed to have. The chi comes out of your lungs and goes into the punch when on impact. The breathing is your chi. One, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Now we're going to do a jab cross hook. a hook that's throwing like kind of like a wide swing, like a wide hand move. That's what a hook is. You can do it with a straight fist up, or you can do it down. However you want to throw it, but I throw a straight fist up because it lands better when it hit. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now we go to the other side. Same thing. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now we're going to do a number four combo, which is jab, cross, hook, cross. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, Thank you. jab, jab, cross, uppercut. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Same thing on the other side. One, two, three, four, by six, seven, eight, nine. Ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now I'm going to teach you high parry, strike, hook. One, two, three, four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19. 20. There you have it, folks. The boxing workout basics. Turning anywhere you want, small space, wherever. Big space, you can do it standing still, you can do it moving around. Which, when you move around, it's more like this. You know. Shadow boxing. Making other combinations. That's what it looks like when you shadow box after doing these combinations. Once you get good, like I said, if you're doing fighting, you're wanting to learn how to punch, basically making a fist, you close your hands like this, curl them up, make a half fist, have your thumb over your first two fingers, not on them, like this. But like this in front, on the side here. And then you want to hit with these two knuckles, not these. But when you punch, you want to rotate the fist. Or you can hit it straight, it don't matter. But I prefer rotating because you add more torque. You add more power to it. And everything else. But as like I said, when you punch, same thing with the other side, when you punch, you know, get used to doing like a karate stance, and then be able to use your whole shoulder into it, whole body into it, hold everything into it. You can do it in a boxing stance too. Other side. Same thing. So basically that's how you punch. You know, sorry I didn't teach you at the beginning of the video, but that's how you punch. But like I said, when you punch, you don't want to use your shoulder. You don't want to be tense when punching in the shoulders. You want to, you know, you want to try to stay loose if you can. That way you get speed into your punches. Power will come later. The powerness will come later into the technique. But once you get the mechanics down of it, the power will come later. Work on mechanics first, of how to do them, and then we'll go from there. I am Sam McDonald Ford. Hit the like, hit the subscribe, leave a comment, hit the bell, hit all on the bell. You'll get all the videos, hit all on the notification bell, buy the subscribe button, hit the subscribe, leave a comment, and peace, train hard, train smart, do your research. Stay tuned for my next video.